My name is Rainer Kuschall. I'm a mountain boy. When I was 14, 15, I had two professional years in ski racing. And I had as well my accident in the mountains by jumping into a swimming pool. And I hit the ground. I could not move anymore. They pulled me out by pulling me on the head. It cracked, and then I was completely paralyzed. Well, I found myself then in a hospital bed. The doctors always said, well, there's hope, but we don't know. Mentally wise, I tried to connect myself back to my body and drove through to my toes and tried to move them. Only after 3, 4, 5 months, you know, you start to realize, oh, nothing comes back anymore. Then we heard about Stoke Mandeville. After 3, 4 days only, I met first time Sir Ludwig Goodman. He is the founder and the leader of the first spinal cord unit rehabilitation center from Berlin. He emigrated in the wartime. When he came first time into the door, I felt that he is a special man. He had a kind of an aura, and I felt right away trustful to him. But the way how he told you things were so direct, he just said, Rainer, we try to bring you now into the vertical position in a wheelchair, but you never will be able to push a wheelchair. The first change they did was turning me every 3 hours on the side, because I was flat all the time on my back. So I was stiff like a piece of wood. So that already was a nightmare, because I right away lost conscience. Yeah, the body is so weak, was so weak, yeah. Then when I was finally able to sit in the chair, and then they pushed me first time into the dining room and meeting all these other people. And, hello, dear, and how are you? And you know, I nearly was fainting all the time. And then I had a very, very tough physio, Maggie. I never will forget her. I strangled her once. I want to kill her. And one day after the physiotherapy, she just pushed me out in the ward, switched the light off, and left me alone. I had no choice, either being there scared or do something. So I saw a light in the front about 30 meters ahead of a broad connection where people still were walking out. So I tried to push my wheelchair the first time. So I put my thumbs in the spokes until they bleed. So meter for meter. It was not willing to push the wheelchair. I was scared and in panic and angry. But that is what she got out of me. That's why she has put me in this situation. So that was the hard way. But thanks to that, I continue my life. When I raced the Berlin Marathon, I faced an emotional situation I never could imagine in my life. And it just was after the fall of the wall. And we went through the Brandenburger Tor, make a loop, and coming back to West Berlin. Put the hand down into the wind. I hear the singing of the bearings and the tires. And suddenly I get goosebumps. And I looked forward, and then I saw the Brandenburger Tor. And suddenly I thought, oh, Pop Goodman, if you would see me now, I'm on world record pace now, racing a wheelchair, with all this historic, and you came from Berlin, emigrated. And suddenly I saw him. With a short smile, and then he went off. Then I remembered, you know, I mean, many years back, He said, Rainer, you'll never be able to push a wheelchair. I mean, these are moments nobody faces in his life, only when he starts to live his dreams. Thank you.